of fishes and eating, and I got a feeling that people don't know the reason why. No need for reeling if someone's concealing this certain produce that's always cheap to buy. Without the sun ever beaming, if I catch a feeling, I'm leaving and I won't even try. I've seen a skunk and think it's all because of a banana, na 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 na. I'm sure you've heard of this superstition if you are fishing. That came from cargo ships, but somehow still a new tradition. They're good for humans if you're talking about the food's nutrition. But if we pack a bunch for lunch, bad luck is too consistent. Just know that accidents may happen when you're cruising with them. If you bring it, don't be surprised if your crew gets distant. I've heard some rumors where captains have one and blew their engine, or stabbed themselves with a gaff. Bananas choose their victim. If consumed, you might just have some puke to deal with. Most definitely it got nothing to do with feeling seasick, not a secret. Frequently it can be an inconvenience to the majority of anglers whose brains think in agreement. Reveal it on board and see if your friends are lenient as you're taken back to shore while receiving a silent treatment. Some don't believe that it's true, but they haven't seen skiffs sink from an evil fruit that's leaving them in some deep shh. Sometimes a fish isn't eating, and I got a feeling that people don't know the reason why. No need for reeling if someone's concealing this certain produce that's always cheap to buy. Without the sun ever beaming, if I catch a feeling, I'm leaving and I won't even try. I've seen a skunk and think it's all because of a banana, na 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 na.
If fishermen don't get a bite, there has to be an excuse. Oddly enough, when it happens, there's usually someone who managed evading the rules and they get accused. It's strange, but basically almost the same as taking a noose. That can explain the Pepe Le Pews. It especially does when my bait is chartreuse. So you wanna win a tournament? You really don't have to work for it. If you can circumvent opponents after you have cursed them with some hidden nourishment in their storage cabinets to turn the myth into reality, then you wouldn't have to be concerned a bit. What more can I say? It only takes a moment trolling the bay to know the dismay from losing your phone or a pole in an ocean or lake. There's no controlling your fate if you're holding a favorite meal to every sort of an ape. I don't even play, just throw them away unless you wanna have a horrible day. I ought to get a whopper following the popper. At the very least, a bluegill on a bobber. Jigging near the bottom is my bread and butter, but I'm out of luck at a spot that's hot as lava. Commonly, my hooks are sharp as Hanzo katanas. We got a problem if you brought a banana. Na 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 na.
Sometimes a fish isn't eating, and I got a feeling that people don't know the reason why. No need for reeling if someone's concealing this certain produce that's always cheap to buy. Without the sun ever beaming, if I catch a feeling, I'm leaving and I won't even try. I've seen a skunk and think it's all because of a banana, na 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 na.
For real though, some fishermen take this very seriously. I mean, not only is banana the fruit a no-no, but some don't even want you saying the word banana. For future notice, don't bring banana boat suntan lotion, banana Laffy Taffies or candies, banana nut muffins or banana bread, banana liquor, clothes from Banana Republic. Don't be singing like Gwen Stefani or this track, for instance. And especially, no banana hammocks allowed on the fishing trip.